Greetings, Cyberdogs! This is Rendog coming at you from just outside the bunghole in this Let's Play Minecraft Survival series. In the previous episode, we were working our ass off on the Nether Portal Temple, and in this episode, we are going to continue doing that. In this episode, we have going to make some more braziers, but this time, we're going to make braziers hanging from the ceiling. There's a freaking carrot, sweet! But I just wanted to come and empty out the bunghole before we start working. We've literally just had a sleep. The sun is on its way up, and we have a full day of Minecraft working to get to. Excuse me, man. Just got a little bit of coffee in my throat there, man. I'm having a tasty coffee today, made by the hands of my girlfriend. Oh, God, it's a good coffee. But here we go, guys. The Nether Portal Temple. I've done a little bit more work on it, so let me take you through it. To show you what we've done, firstly, I've figured out finally how to make these steps. So I'm going to be completing the steps for each of the pillars. And I've tried out a new design on this wall of the temple. As you can see, I've added another cross beam of nether brick across the top of the vertical glass walls. And I really think that that ties the whole temple together. I think that, look at that, man. I really love what this beam does, because if you look at this side, there's actually just too much glass, and one of the Cyberdogs actually commented that it doesn't feel like the temple has space inside the temple because of the glass, right? Basically, they were saying it isn't dark enough up in here, and I agree with that, and I think that this this extra beam of nether brick really adds something, really just completes it, man. Oh man, nether brick, you complete me. So that's what I'm going to be doing today, guys. I also wanted to plant my nether wart. I've got 48 nether wart to plant over here. So let's do that. I wanted to see what that would look like in here. So let's plant the nether wart into the soul sand. So it's going to be on this side. This is basically going to be our nether wart farm. And let's just do this randomly, and then we'll go do it on the other side also. And in the witch's cave, I'm also going to plant some nether wart. So whenever I need nether wart, I'm going to come to the temple or to the witch's cave. But we're going to have to wait for this nether wart to grow and harvest it again so that we can plant some more. But that is looking sweet, man. Check how nasty that is looking up in this temple now, man. That is looking awesome. Oh yeah, check, it's already growing. Damn, man, this temple is such a beautiful ecosystem for nether wart to grow. Look at it, it's going crazy. That's awesome. All right, guys, so I think for a first step, why don't we complete the steps of the pillars? And I wanted to show you how we actually do this. So we got to take these out, right? No, oh Lord. Okay, let's do this a little bit more carefully. So here are our steps. We've got to have these two steps facing this way. Now, what the trick is to do here is to make this step face the lava, right? So you've got to get into a position where you can place the step just like this, facing the lava like that, right? You guys see that? I think I just lost some brickage there, but such is the sacrifice for awesomeness. Alright, so we're facing the lava. Let's just get to the brick. We place the brick, and then we place the middle one, and bam, there you have it. I was going to fix a spade up in here too. Let's fix that spade. Get rid of this filth. Get out of my temple, man. You are not welcome here, dirt. Dirt is for noobs. Alright, so there we go, guys. Looking good. I must say, and now what we're going to do is add just a single layer of fencing, just like that. And as you can see, that gives the desired effect of the first one that we made. So that is sweet. Here's one I prepared earlier. I already sorted this one out. And now all we've got to do is this one. Let's see if we can do it from here. Yeah, we can. Okay, so here we go. Bam! Bam! Sweet! Oh man, epic. There we go. Beautiful. Absolutely beautiful, man. I'm loving that. I wonder if we even want to go one level higher. Oh, no, we can't because it's a step. I think I tried it before. It looks pretty terrible. So that's looking sweet. As you can see, I've already added another pillar over here. If you guys want to see that building, I suggest going to watch Dogmail number 5. I've got some footage of me building these extra walls and stuff in Dogmail number 5 if you want to see how I built these walls. But I think we're going to build one of these together. The only problem is, guys, we are running out of glass. We're going to have to go on a glass farming mission very, very soon. I mean, is it surprising that we're running out of glass? I mean, check how much glass we're using here. It's crazy. But we've literally gone through, I don't know, probably 10 stacks of glass, if not more, at this stage. But what I wanted to do now, guys, is complete this extra beam of nether brickage up in here. Because I really think this is exactly what these glass walls needed. And it just brings the whole thing together so nicely. It also kind of lets us finish off the braziers from outside. Because right now, the braziers are exposed to the elements. It's not really making sense, is it? There is a bit of a, I don't know, it's just like a design blunder. It's kind of annoying me, actually. So maybe we should try and finish these off. So if we did this, and now they're finished off. Sweet. We probably want to do one more like that also. And it kind of, oh man, that is pretty sweet. Because it kind of makes it like they are metal support beams or so. Kablam, kablam, kablam. Nice. And one higher for all of them. Man, we are going through so much irons. I'm so happy we went on that slime hunting mission and got all that extra iron because we are running dry on iron. In this episode, I actually wanted to make these hanging braziers also. There you can see the one that we've made. And for that, we need nether rails. We've got some, I think. We've used it all. Damn, son! Right, so we're going to have to make some more nether rails. It's exactly the same as fences, right? It's nether fences. There we go. So we'll make... Yeah, we'll make some amount of the nether brick fence. I mean, we could use nether brick fence around here, but I kind of like the way that the iron and the nether brick looks. I also wanted to fill up these things with lava also. I wanted to fill up these lava pits, but I think in this episode, we gotta stay focused here, man. We gotta make these braziers. But what we are gonna need to do is get some more iron. Because we are running out of iron fences. So let's head to the forge room. Looks like the sun is about to go down too. So we'll probably go for a little snooze also. I'm sure we've got some irons in here. 64 iron in the belly. Damn. Check how many levels I get for this, man. This is awesome. Boom. Sweet. All right, let's head down to the crafting room. Hello, doggies. How's it going, doggies? Right. Let's make some more railage. Biome! Okay, that was maybe overkill on the railage, but that's all good, man. We'll put the rest of our refined urn away in its appropriate box. There we go. You're all good, doggies, right? Check, they're talking to each other now. Good, you've accepted... You've accepted Fido into the pack, have you, Jock Rorschach? You've accepted him. Good. I like it. Everybody's getting along really, really well. But guys, the sun is about to go down, it seems. So it is bedtime for me. I'll see you on the other side of this kaplam. Kaplam. That was a good sleep, man. Gee, a day in Minecraft goes so freaking fast. It's unbelievable. Seriously. I'm not sure exactly how long a day is. I think it's something like 10 minutes. Not entirely sure on that, but check it out, man. The sun coming up and this design over here, having the gap in the middle. Man, you cyberdogs are so smart. That was a cyberdog suggestion. And I freaking love that idea because you can actually see the sun rising through this gap. The sun actually rises directly in the middle of this line, which is just so sweet. It's unbelievable. Okay, so this second brazier needs to go up in the middle there. So 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So 1, 2, 3. So it's in this one right here. Let's try get some height up in here. So let's check it out. 1, 2, 3. Plyum. Lead. There we go. That's what we need. And how many things did I make it? 1, 2, 3. Fell. Fell. I think it's fell. Right. So we. Oh man, we're gonna have to make sure, aren't we? Let's check. 1, 2, 3. Fell. And then on the fourth, we've got the rails coming out. Okay, that makes sense. Man, my memory is so bad. I have such a short freaking memory, guys. Seriously. So that we're actually on the fourth right now. So now what we're going to do is build the nether rail holding thingies. That's what I'm calling them. That's the official name for them. The nether rack holding thingy. Because these are like the teeth, I guess, that are going to be hanging on to... hanging onto the brazier itself. Bam! Bam! And then in this space here is going to be the flame. And then, so what we need to do is get the iron railage going down like this. And then we'll fix this up right away. And then we'll stick the nether rack in there, just like that. Then what we need to do, man, check it, the nether wart farm down there, man. It is nasty. It's freaking stinky up in here, man. It smells like old feet. Right, so now we're completing the brazier as so. See how easy it is, guys. Bam. And then what we need to do is go a little bit up also. To complete the top layer of the cage, but not like that. Please tell me that I brought my flint and steel. Oh, you bastard. Okay, so we're gonna have to go back and get our flint and steel, because we definitely got to set this on fire right now. Oh man, this is gonna be sweet. I love these braziers, man. The netherrack is just the most awesome thing ever. Right, where is our flint and steel? There. Man, this flint and steel is almost dead. Back to the brazier we go. Right, let's set this puppy on fire. Close off the fencage. And that is that, man. That is brazier number 2 completed. And let's just have a look at that, what that looks like. Looking sweet. And we should be able to see both of them now on either side of the table. Look at that, man. Oh, God. It's just too much of awesome. The awesomeness is overwhelming me. Right, I want to continue adding to that effect. So what I want to do now is actually complete the lava pits around the temple. So I want to complete this one and the other one and that one. And what I wanted to experiment with today is actually opening up this this line of so it's going to look like the lava is actually flowing from underneath. You see what I mean? I think that's actually really cool. Yeah, I like that. I think we'll keep that. That is sweet. All right, so let's get rid of this line of netherrack. Hey. And the lava's gonna go in here. So how many buckets we're gonna need? We're probably gonna need 4 buckets, I guess. I really like this effect. Instead of making the lava completely flat, I actually like making it look like it's flowing, if you know what I'm saying. Speaking of flowing, let's get rid of these. Nice. I wish we could actually do it on this side too, but if we broke this netherrack here, we would destroy the redstone wirage of the butthole, of the nether portal butthole, so that is unfortunate. Unless I move the pressure plate to here, then we might do that, but I don't know if the door opens quick enough if you move the pressure plates there. So maybe that is something for us to experiment with. But let's get the lava up in here. One. Okay, last time we did this, we fell in the lava. That's why I've got this bucket of water, just in case. One, two, three. And fell. Right, let's see how that looks. Looking good. And now let's get some glass up in here. Man, this Nether Portal Temple is a crazy place to come, man. Damn. I think when we do molehole tours, I don't know if we'll bring people to the Nether Portal Temple, man. They'll ask for their money back. They'll come in here and feel like they've walked straight into hell. Imagine how hot it must be down here, man. Damn. Right, now what I want to do lastly in this episode, guys, is finish off this pillar. Because, you know, it doesn't really make sense that we've made two of them. I don't know if we will have one over here. We might have one sticking out. I don't know. We still have to do a lot of work on deciding on how that's going to work. But let's finish this lava pillar up in here. And I think it's one more. Sweet! Oh, man. sigh. We dropped off all of our nether bricks by mistake. Right, let's pick them up again. Sweet! Oh, man, guys. I can't believe how awesomely the Nether Portal Temple is turning up in the end. Damn! I mean, if you guys remember, this was just a flat, leveled out piece of land, and now it is looking like something freaking epic. By far the biggest thing that I've ever built in Minecraft ever. And I'm so happy with it, man. It is so sweet. All right, there we go. Although there isn't enough redstones and stuff for me at the moment inside of the temple. I wish there was more. I don't know how we're going to make the redstone drawbridges, but maybe that's something we'll try and work on in the next episode. Right, we need two buckets of lava for this one. And I think that is basically it. Let's get rid of the dirtage. And let's go inside to have a look at what it looks like. Man, this is going to be sweet. We still have to do two braziers, but oh, it is starting to take form. And I'm telling you, man, these beams is what is bringing it all together. I'm absolutely loving the beams. Right, what we need to do now is finish these two walls of glass and then figure out how we're going to be connecting the entrance to the temple itself, guys. But that is going to be for another day. Right now, we are heading over to the Dogolith, guys, because I owe you guys quite a few Dogolith entries. I think we'll do four of you onto the Dogolith today, and then we're going to call it a day, man. Wow, this episode has flown by, and we've achieved quite a lot, though. You know, we made the lava pits, we finished off the lava pillars on the side of the wall. We just did so much in this episode. Can't believe how quickly it flew by. But before we get to the Dogolith, we need to deal with our freaking digestion problem, man. Damn, got constipation up in here. Sweet. Right, level 19, man. We are heading toward level 30 because we want to get a fortune pickaxe as soon as we possibly can. Oh, man. I wish we could just get a fortune pickaxe. But every time we try to enchant a pickaxe, the last time we enchanted one, all we got was Unbreaking 3, which made us very sad. But guys, it is Dogolith time. We're going to get four Dogolith signs on the Dogolith. So that means 8 of you from the YouTube subscriber list and 8 of you from dogcraft.net. So without further ado, guys, let's start with YouTube. Wait, this side is almost finished, so we're gonna have to do 3 on this side and 1 on the other side, but let's start with YouTube. So to start with, we've got a sweet ass name, man, the human Dung Beetle. Welcome to the Doggolith, my friend. We've also got Cyber Dog Zillionaire. That's definitely not going to fit, but Zillionaire. Air. Zillionaire. Okay, you know who you are. Welcome to the Doggolith, my friend. We've also got Undead Rico. Welcome to the Doggolith, Undead Rico. And we've also got Wombat Y. Wombat Y? 26,000. Welcome to the Doggolith, Wombat Y. 262,000. Damn, they're 262,000 Wombat Ys. Still from YouTube, my friends. We have got M. King. Welcome to the Doggolith, Mr. M. We've also got Krusk. And we've got Retribution's Blade. Welcome to the Doggolith, Blade. And lastly but not leastly, we've got Rezia. Kramer. Sorry if I got that wrong, but you know who you are. Welcome to the Doggolith. And I think we're going to go around to the other side of the Doggolith for our Dogcraft entries. And from dogcraft.net, we have got NC... Wait, hang on. I can't read my own handwriting. I think this is UC Tix 11. I don't know. That could be wrong. Welcome to the Doggolith, my friend. We've also got Ninja Cyberdog. Welcome to the Doggolith, my friend. And we've got Spider Dragon 82. Man, there are 82 Spider Dragons in the world. That is some scary ass business. We've also got N Paz 96. Welcome to the Doggolith, my friend. And the last four entries for today goes to WWE Master 76. Sweet. Welcome to the Doggolith, WWE Master 76. Good to have you, man. We've also got J-R-L-U-L-U-L-F-R-I-C. Jarl Yulfric. Welcome to the Doggolith. We've also got the Josie 84. Welcome to the Doggolith, Josie. And lastly for today, guys, we've got Venfly. Welcome to the Doggolith, my friend. And guys, remember, if you want to get your asses on the Doggolith, you need to be a subscriber of this channel. Oh man, look at that blood moon rising over the freaking Nether Portal Temple. That is so sweet. Check it out, guys. Oh my goodness. Anyway, if you want to get your asses on the Doggolith, guys, you need to be a subscriber of the Rendog channel and leave me a constructive comment every now and then. I pick you guys from complete random, and anyone who asks to be put on the Doggolith is immediately ignored, guys. So it is just a gamble. It is the lottery. You may get on, you may not, but that is how it works. Or you can join dogcraft.net. There is a thread there in the forums where you can put your YouTube username to get to stand a chance of being on the Doggolith. But guys, this has been Rendog playing Minecraft Survival 1.4. I hope you've enjoyed it. The Nether Portal Temple is almost finished, and hopefully in the next couple of episodes we'll be able to finish the bulk of it. And thank you so much for freaking watching. I cannot wait to see you in the next video, guys. I hope you're all having an amazing holiday time. And if you are from somewhere in the future, the world hasn't ended, which is sweet. And welcome. Welcome to the series. There's way more to come, man. Guys, this has been Rendog, and it's time to sign off. We'll see you in the next episode. Goodbye, my friends!